Hello?
Anna, it's Tom Hardy. I hope I'm not disturbing you.
No, no, not at all. Is everything all right? Did you talk to Olivia?
Oh, yes. She's coming in this morning.
Well, you know what to ask her.
Of course. Did she go to Duke's Club the other night, and if so, why?
There's no why about it. She remembers everything. If we get this information, Tom, we can send her to trial.
Listen, Anna, I'll do whatever I can to find out what her version of the truth is.
All right. Well, thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Oh, gosh, Mom, did you hear that?
Oh,
what are they going to do?
What are you going to do?
You know, Felicia and Colton, the wedding. Oh, my gosh, can you see Felicia standing there in her soggy dress and wet hair?
No, I can't. You know what?
What?
Nothing's going to stop this wedding. It's going to be beautiful.
Really?
Well, he's a bit wet.
That's the handkerchief you carried when you married Uncle Duke, isn't it?
Yeah, I didn't think you'd remember that. You want to carry it when you get married, maybe?
Really? You let me?
Yeah, of course. I'm going to lend it to Felicia today. This is going to be something borrowed.
It's very nice of you.
So you can wait down here for me if you like.
No, I'll go up with you. I want to check with Dr. Hardy to see if he has any special instructions for me.
For me?
No, no, for me.
Oh, I see. Yeah. I don't understand it. I don't understand it at all. Don't people in this town have anything better to do than to follow me around? How dare they?
It's not an accusation, Olivia. It's a question.
I resent it.
Well, I'm sorry about that, but stop resenting it for a moment and answer it. You're right, maybe we're all a bunch of busybodies. But the question is, did you go to Duke's Club the other night after the engagement party for Felicia and Colton?
It's not even Duke's Club anymore. Some Terry person bought it, and she's going to gut it and ruin everything.
Ruin everything?
Yes. Yes, she's going to ruin everything. And yes, I did go to Duke's Club the other night. Nora just has to sleep sometimes. Please don't be angry with Nora. I just couldn't sleep. I was in a lot of grief.
In grief about what? Why is the club going to be ruined?
Because I've been trying to do what you've been asking me to do. I don't remember anything. It's just that I have these vague feelings. So I thought if I went to the club before it's all changed around and everything, that's what I meant by ruined. Ruined as a place of memory for me, that I might remember something.
You thought the place would trigger it?
Yes. Those questions that my father's lawyer asked me, they told me a story that I don't remember. I thought maybe if I went to the club, I might remember having an affair with this man named Duke. Did I love him? Did he love me?
And?
And what?
Olivia, you know what I'm talking about. What did you remember?
Don't you think I would have told you something if I would have remembered it? Doctor, the most important thing to me right now is that I get full recall of my memory. That's what you've been telling me.
Olivia, sit down. You're getting yourself very upset.
I'm very upset is exactly right. People have been telling me that I was madly in love with a man that I barely remember. They're telling me that I tried to tie him to me. It's not my memory I'm scared of anymore. Only a crazy woman would do the things that they said that I did. I'm afraid I'm not sane.
Well, you would know more about that than I would.
How's that? You're the doctor.
You're the one inside your own head. You think you're not sane. Why?
I don't know. Everything's just all locked up. I want to find out what's wrong with me.
I have an idea that might help.
What is it? I'll do it.
It's a drug. It's called sodium pentothal. It's not strong, has no lasting effects. It's generally used to sedate patients before they go into surgery.
Isn't that what they used to call truth serum?
Some people still do.
How could drugs make my memory come back clearer than an undrugged mind? I don't understand that.
Olivia, there is a chemical explanation, and I will give it to you. But believe me for now, sodium pentothal works.
Let's do it then. I'll do anything to get my memory back. For better or for worse. Can we do it this afternoon?
I'm sorry, I'm booked this afternoon. What do you say we do it tomorrow afternoon? 2 o'clock?
The sooner the better.
Okay.
I want to do this to ease everybody's mind, and I'm sure Anna Lavery will want to find the truth out as soon as possible.
I'm sure she'll be interested.
Good. I'll see you tomorrow, then.
Okay.
Nora wanted to know if you had any special instructions for her.
Nothing I can think of off the top of my head, just to have you here tomorrow.
You know, Tom, I think Nora has a crush on you.
Sienna Lavery.
That this is very short notice, sir, but, you know, if you could just try really, really hard, I'm sure you could do this today. Please? Yes, I want them delivered. All of it. Read me back the list, would you? Thank you. Yeah. No, 3 bottles of wine, please, and send the bill to me. Yes, you have my address. Thank you. Okay, bye-bye.
Oh, God. And just... moments before the big wedding, Anna Lavery, matron of honor, ties up last-minute detail on the countdown to wedding 1989.
Oh, Tiffany, please, you've got to switch that camera off, you know. It's just driving me insane, and this whole day is, like, not even on yet.
I'm sorry. Well, I mean, you know, weddings do that to everybody. I was just in there. I just shot Robin. By the way, Robin, I actually taped her. Well, I didn't tape her. I actually recorded her. You know, she really likes this stuff. She likes the pose. She should be in movies. I could help her.
Well, you could help her be in movies?
Yeah.
Can you make it as far away from the state as possible? Is she dressed yet?
No, she's not dressed. She can't decide between her pink blouse or her blue blouse, you know.
What difference does it make? She's going to be in the bridesmaid's dress in a while. Oh,
well, you know, she's young. Just give her a few minutes, you know. And while we're waiting for her, I wonder if, well, you know, people think I'm whacked out of my gourd half the time, you know, and people don't know if I'm being serious about things, and I would like to talk to you about something kind of serious, if it's okay.
Yeah, sure.
You know, I try to very hard to imagine what I would have done. I mean, if I had been through what you've been through in the last few weeks. I mean, you know, losing Duke like you did, and you know, all the horrible grief you had with Mav and Olivia and all that. You know, and I wonder what would I do. You know, and I think I would absolutely have fallen apart. I would probably just melted like the Wicked Witch of the West or something. You know?
No, you wouldn't. You're a strong lady.
No, I'm just looked that way because I'm tall. You know, but you, I mean, you have just. Things are the most horrendous thing in the world, and you've just come out so strong, and I kind of consider you like my female version of a hero, I guess.
Oh, thanks. Yeah. I'd like people to think that, you know.
But yeah.
You know, this serious stuff, you know. Don't do it again.
No,
that upsets me.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to upset you. I didn't mean to upset you.
Let's
you know.
Go. We'll
kind of give me heart attack. I just
want to...
Felicia, this
yes.
won't do it all. Robin cannot even get her big toe in these shoes. That's ridiculous.
What's the thing we're trying to do? Give me a nervous breakdown?
Oh, dear.
I'll give her a new one.
Yes.
I know. Well,
I can't believe they don't work. Tremendous
oh,
force, and they didn't. They were supposed to stitch the thing into the shoulder.
I don't have a needle.
They just all right, listen, I am awfully good at last-minute needle and thread emergencies.
Do you have a needle and thread?
Yes, I'll get it. I know where it is.
I can't believe it. What shoes am I going to wear?
I will go to the store. This is Tiffany. She'll go to the store, and she will get you the size that fits, okay?
Take back anything that doesn't work. No, this isn't right. No.
I'm sorry, but this is exactly the way you said you wanted it.
Look at it.
Mr. Hairdresser, excuse me, honey. Why don't you just take a long break? Why don't you go there and help with the hair? Mr. Hairdresser, would you come with me? I need help with these shoes.
I can maybe do something if you like. Should I do something?
Here, take this. Would you?
Oh my goodness. Oh, careful. Does this hurt? What did you do here? No, I'm starving.
Where's my bouquet? I think I'd like to eat it.
Eat some food in here? Maybe we can make you a sandwich or something. Do you want to
dress that up? You see my dress? If I eat one little carrot, one thin little carrot, I'll burst out of it.
Oh, well, that's just paranoia. Come on, you're going to look beautiful in it. Don't worry.
Oh, I will.
Can you believe this is happening?
Yes.
Yeah, you will. You will too.
That's the right kind of attitude.
Yes.
Yeah, you know what? Before I forget, I want to give you this. This is brand new. I got it from the bank this morning, okay? Brand new penny. There you go.
Something new.
Okay, you just polish that up a little.
Thank you. 1989.
Maybe this is the hairdresser coming.
Hello.
Come in.
Whoa, yeah. Progress is slow in here, isn't it?
Yeah, that's for sure.
But you know what? Mom just gave Felicia a brand new shiny penny from the bank. And now all she needs is something old, something borrowed, and blue.
Something blue?
Oh, you got a blue one?
We got it. Oh, that's blue. You would be the one to give me that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is great.
Thank you.
Hi.
You can borrow this. I used it when I got married, and, it's... I'm going to need it later when Robin gets married, but you can borrow it now, if you like.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And I was thinking about what I was going to give you and Colton, you know. I mean, I don't want to give you a food processor or anything like that, the toaster. But maybe, if you like, you can both use the cabin for your honeymoon. Duke and I have had some wonderful times up there, and I'd like you to use it. I think that there should be some food and wine in it by now. I kind of stocked it up earlier, but please.
I would love to. Thank you very much. That's the best. Thank you.
His leg, skinny.
Very funny. I'm glad you guys are here to make this, because I am not. Are you just about finished there? Sorry, I mean, I don't mean to crush you. Talking to me? I'm not talking.
Hello, Felicia Jones' apartment.
Anna, I'm glad I got you.
What is it, Tom?
Listen, I have some news. I don't know how good it will be. I spoke with Olivia this morning about taking sodium pentothal to help recover her lost memory.
Did she agree to it?
Well, she's aware that it's sometimes called truth serum. But yes, she agreed.
She did. Tom, this could give us the evidence we need. We could send her to trial for what she did.
Yes, I need to speak with Dr. Forrest, please. Of course he's busy. He's the head of the hospital. Just tell him it's Olivia Jerome. You don't understand. Just tell him who's calling. Thank you. Yes, Dr. Forrest, how are you? I know. It was awful about Daddy. I'm just sick. I feel so helpless. Well, you've done so much for him already. Thank you. Well, I know he'd love for you to visit him. Yes, I'm calling with another question. I need to know everything I can about sodium pentothal. Do you work with that a lot? I thought you would. Well, I just need to learn everything I can about it. How it works, what dosage works, how it has an effect, and most of all, how it's administered. Oh, yes, I'm taking notes.
Yeah, okay. All right. All right, well, I'll see you at the wedding, Tom, then. Yeah, thank you very much. Okay, bye-bye.
I'll get it.
Thank you. Sean's place is a madhouse. I had to get out of there.
You can't stay here. You have to leave. You can't stay.
Oh, I just want to see Felicia.
No, you
just for a couple of minutes, please. I'm going nuts.
Wait! You can't see Felicia. You know it's against the rules.
Yeah, but okay. See was the wrong choice of words. How about talk to? I'll stand on this side of the door. She can stand on that side of the door, and we'll just talk, please.
Well, what do you want to talk about?
I'm going to hold my breath.
Well, stay here. You look very nice.
Thank you.
Do you have a tie? Around your neck?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, wait here. Don't peek.
Wait a minute.
Felicia, you have a visitor.
You can't see me yet. It's not because it's bad luck, but because I don't look very good.
Oh, that's all right. I can wait a few more hours. Ah, can you believe this? In a few more hours, we're going to be married. We're going to be Mr. and Mrs. Colton Shore. Mm-hmm. Felicia.
Yeah?
Are you nervous?
Uh-huh.
Hey, listen. I think our prayers have been answered.
I don't hear anything.
Exactly. No thunder, no lightning, no rain.
Oh, don't say that just yet.
Yeah, well, I can, because I promised you we were going to have a perfect wedding. And we are. I love you.
I love you.
Is everyone here?
The whole town is here for your small wedding.
Oh. I can hear everybody out there. I knew this place would take on a life of its own. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's the way it should be. All your planning is working out, and now it's out of your hands.
I'm so glad that all my friends are here. The happiest day of my life.
Come on, come on, come on.
Yeah, I've got to get going. I've licked my lips off.
No.
Can you line it?
Can I? You want me to line your lips?
Would you? Well,
because you can't do it at all.
It's raining.
Tony, here she is.
Oh, and she looks like such a beautiful bride.
Very special.
Who is it that gives this woman in holy matrimony?
I do.
Dearly beloved, we have gathered here in the beauty of this park to join together this man and this woman in the holy bonds of wedlock. The rings, please. Hold them and place the ring on your bride's finger.
Felicia, I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow.
Felicia?
I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow.
Into the holy union of matrimony, Felicia and Colton have come to be joined. If there is anyone here who knows just cause why these two may not lawfully be joined together in marriage, speak now or forever hold your peace. Now that Colton and Felicia have given themselves to each other with solemn vows, the joining together of hands and the exchange of their wedding rings, I do now pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of God. God has put it together like no man with a son. Colton, you may kiss your bride. Felicia, you may kiss your groom.
Thank you, sir.
There you go.
Felicia, you want to take your flowers? Colton's arm. Ladies and gentlemen, I know you will want to join me in greeting Mr. and Mrs. Colton Shore.
Congratulations, you have an incredible woman.
Thank you.
That he does.
Mr. Donnelly.
You know what I loved is that you both looked so happy when you said I do.
Happy? That's not even the word.
Well, in my line of work, I'm not used to talking to newlyweds, except maybe when I can. I just like to say that, I wish you more happiness than is technically good for your health.
Oh, I think that'd be nice to
you. Oh, really? You like that?
I like that.
Wait a minute, one more thing. Just to sort of get this off on the right foot, I think from now on it should be Mrs. Colton Shore.
Hey. Oh, you like that? Sure, I like it.
Yeah, you can kiss me.
I love it, Mrs. Colton.
Yeah?
Sure.
Well, you kiss me. I think this sort of thing should be back in the motel.
He's a killer.
Don't move. They will die.
What do you want?
You will come with us quietly.
And if I don't?
Do you want to be killed? The first bullet will be for the bride.
Get in real close.
Hello.
I'm just.
You should have seen this blushing bride when we were in Africa.
What?
We'd been out in the wilderness all day long, and she was an absolute mess. Absolutely filthy, dirty, from head to toe.
So I'm like a dirty.
Ooh. Oh, I'm sure she cleaned up good. Yes.
I think she scrubs up remarkably well.
Yeah, I'm going to have to take your word on it, but she certainly smells clean.
Yeah. Honey, do you get the feeling that you are the star attraction here?
No, I think we're the star attraction.
Uh-oh.
I think we're about to get wet.
Yeah, Sean Donnelly was just telling me he's going to move a party inside, I think.
Well, that's why you really think it's going to rain, isn't it?
Yeah, I know. It was tempting fate by having a wedding reception outdoors, but I wanted to dance under the stars with my new husband.
Well, not tonight.
Excuse me.
Okay.
We just got one more close-up. One more
close-up.
No. Come on. Yeah. Close-up. Now, what I want you to do on this is the best part. I want...
Bye.
Felicia.
Bye.
Yes. Look at the man as though he's the only man in the world.
You have to act.
Okay, now do something steamy, Colton. I mean, you know, steamy romantic.
Something steamy and romantic.
The only man in the world.
Oh, my goodness.
No, you cannot have any yet. You've got to wait.
Oh, Tiffany.
Dear, it doesn't look as though it's going to go away.
I know. I can't believe it picked tonight of all nights.
Oh, I don't care. All I see is
me. I love you. I think that's why I'm married.
Well, you know, rain can be romantic, but it's
yeah, I think it's time for Plan B.
What Plan B?
If it's got a roof, I'll buy it.
Okay. Yeah. How about Duke's Club?
Yeah, good idea.
Well, I am, but I mean, we can make do. We can dance on the sawdust.
Why not?
My first dance. If that's what you all want.
No, honey. Dance on
the stars. One time for it.
I love stars. And now it's your
turn. Go for it.
All right, you two go dance, but you may have to finish it under an umbrella.
Just stand and be wet by the time we get there.
Look who's here.
Oh,
perfect couple, don't they?
Yes. Oh, that they do.
6-5, they don't get through the second throw. Plan B.
Yes.
There it is.
Looks beautiful. Thank you.
Okay, well, if you'll excuse me for just a moment. Tony, it's time to get this show on the road.
Yeah? Okay, what about the music?
Well, I'll turn it down, then you take over.
Okay, I guess somebody's got to make a speech.
Let's cut the cake.
Oh, Robin.
Hey, kid's got a point. Let it go. Hey, let's get some
work up.
Let's cut the cake!
Okay.
All right, you ready?
Now remember, you guys, you have to eat the first piece.
Okay. Since when are we such an authority on weddings?
Oh, she's an expert. She's been to enough weddings.
Haven't we all?
No, she went to mine.
Ready, ready?
Yes, do it.
Oh. Count of three. One, two, three.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Slice number one. Slice number two.
Here you go. You do the honors,
okay.
I get the plate.
That's the kind of
thing
I like.
Oh, you like that piece?
Oh, that's delicious.
We have to eat first. At least as big as that, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
All right, don't bother with fork, honey.
Oh, man, an animal.
That's nice.
That's nice.
It is.
Jay, you're not going anywhere until you give the rest of us a chance. Come on.
I couldn't help but notice how you and Sam were cutting the rug out there. It was great.
Oh, hey, you weren't so bad yourself. But who is that guy you're with doing the curly shuffle?
Oh, him. He's just somebody I picked up on the street.
Really?
Yeah, right up front.
Ready?
Okay, well, now everybody group in. Oh, we got one more cut.
Okay, here it goes, all right? Mr.
Very nice catch, Bobby. Now for all you poor single guys, time to improve your luck.
Oh, now I've got just the thing to improve.
I thought you might.
Oh, I love this part. Hey, let me.
There it is.
No more than you were of the bouquet.
I was talking with Walt.
Oh, so yeah. You say.
I think you're just covering up the fact that you're a chicken.
Oh, wait. Is that a kettle looking for a black pot, huh?
Here we go. One, two, three.
All right, he's gone.
right.
Where is he? I don't believe it. Sean, DJ didn't get the part. I hire a professional. He doesn't get the part. Look at that. It was great.
Well, honey, at least you remembered how to turn the video camera.
What's the ring on your bride's finger?
That's not funny. I was confused. I didn't know how to do that. I had so many buttons on that stupid thing, I didn't know how it worked.
Oh, it's a good thing you got one of the guys from the station to do it. Otherwise,
we wouldn't have a video at all of the wedding, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Lost all that pre-wedding stuff. I can't believe, you know, we had little BJ walking down with little petals going every place, and we had, you know, Mariah came out.
Honey, don't worry about it. The most important thing is you got all the wedding, the guests. And besides, I don't think Felicia and Colton are going to miss me standing here in my bathrobe and slippers taking the cleaning. Oh, Anna.
Hi.
Come on in. You're just in time to see the videotapes of the wedding.
Yes, yes, thank you.
Oh, thanks.
Much.
You'd like it?
Yeah, I did. It's good.
Good.
Oh, yeah, it's pretty great. Hey, that's so clear. Oh, it's beautiful. That's a nice thing for them to have, isn't it?
Oh, well, it goes to show.
What kind of quality you get when you hire a professional?
Oh, yeah? Who's that?
DJ, yes.
No, it's beautiful. It's really odd.
Oh,
so
happy. They're so gorgeous together, aren't they?
Yeah.
See, all that worrying and fretting you did, Sean, it was dealt with to no avail. And let me tell you, Anna, the night before the wedding, he set the alarm every hour, on the hour, to get up just so he could check the weather.
All right. I admit I'm guilty. But those are the problems you face when you try to have an outdoor wedding in a park.
See? Like right back there in the tunnel there?
Oh, it was dark.
Honey, you don't look at the lighting. You can't get it if you don't have good lighting. You got bad people. You can't do it. I've told people that a million times. Oh, for goodness sake. Well, I suppose that's what happens when you have like a wedding in a public place. Nosy Parkers.
Nosy Parkers.
It'd be Freddy the Freeloader. I'll pre-frame it.
Honey, don't hit the erase button, please.
That's cute.
Mm.
Okay. That's a predictor.
Let's see. Oh, it's probably just one of the truck
drivers. Are these like up for grabs? Can we have anybody have these?
Yeah.
I have a little coffee. Might look at the camera.
Lift
the energy. Oh, that was the guy. Well, that's a beautiful wedding.
It's all the wrist.
The wrist?
Yes, yes. Plus the fact I know how to push all the right buttons.
Ooh, oh, I heard sure that about do. You. Yeah, you know how to push the telephone buttons. You got a great caterer, didn't you?
Yes.
Oh, speaking of, you want some fresh coffee? I can make a pot in no time.
I got to go over to General Hospital. Oh. Tom Hardy's going to be questioning Olivia today.
Yeah, you know, I still can't figure out why she agreed to use sodium pentothal.
Hmm. Olivia agreed to truth serum?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, telling the truth is going to be a whole new experience for that lady.
It makes you wonder, though, why would she agree to be questioned under such a heavy drug if she really had something to hide?
Well, I don't know. Maybe she thinks she can get around it somehow.
Well, if she does, she's in for one big surprise.
Hmm. See, this could give us the proof we need to send her to trial. That's what I'm hoping for.
Well, I hope they put her away until her roots grow out.
Yeah.
It'll be a long time.
I think I'll go over to the hospital with you.
Oh, no, that's okay. You don't have to. I don't need an escort.
Well, it's not a question of being an escort. Oh. It's, a question of me being your partner, and I do have a professional interest in this case.
Well, you're my friend, too, aren't you?
That's true.
Yeah.
Well, if you two guys are going to go to work, I am going down, and I'm going to start editing the wedding tape.
Excuse me, Mr. Ohm's here for her appointment with Dr. Hardy. We're just a little bit early.
Yes, ma'am. He is expecting you. Please go right up, and Nurse Finding will meet with you.
The moment of truth has arrived. Mm-hmm. Okay, you're all set. Now, you'll just feel a sensation coming up your arm, kind of like a wave, and then you'll feel very calm and tranquil, or at least that's what they tell me. Mm-hmm. So I'll go get Dr. Hardy. Just be still.
As well get started, Amy.
Get started.
Okay, great. Mm. Olivia, what I want you to do now is count backwards from 100, okay?
Nice.
Lavey. It's Dr. Hardy. Can you hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Do you remember where we are?
General Hospital.
Do you feel all right? Comfortable?
I feel fine.
Good. Now I'm going to ask you a few questions. I'd like you to answer them the best you can. Just relax and answer them as freely as possible. Do you understand?
I understand.
Do you know who Anna Lavery is?
Yes, of course.
Do you remember where you first saw her? Olivia. Amy, check the dosage. Olivia,
it's
can you
minimal.
Hear me? Amy, stop the IV.
I feel sick.
Olivia,
I feel
just
really
try
sick.
To lay back and
no,
relax,
I'm really
okay?
Sick.
Olivia.
I'm really sick.
Come on, try not to make any sudden movements.
I'm going to get really sick.
Amy, why don't you take care of
her? Come on, come on, come on, can you get up? Come on, come on.
She seems to have had an allergic reaction to sodium pentothal. She
couldn't tolerate
it.
Oh, that is rubbish.
Look, Anna, I'm sorry. The drug is not going to be of any use to us.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Tom.
Look, if I can think of anything
else,
I'll
tell
you. You'll
tell us. You'll let us, all right.
I knew she was trying to get around it somehow. How can you do this?
Anna, it doesn't surprise me, especially after she agreed to take that drug.
Can you counteract it? What is it? Can you take
yes,
a pill
can.
Or something?
Yes, you can. I don't know exactly what it is, but
well,
yes,
why don't
you
they
can.
Tell us about this? Why do does everybody...
Can you
hold the elevator door?
Yeah.
Take a deep breath. Oh, Mrs. Lavery, I'm so sorry.
You're sorry? I'm sure you're sorry. You know, you're not fooling anyone,
Anna. I tried to help you.
Yes?
You can keep this act up forever, you know, but I'm going to be there the day that this all falls apart, and I'm going to see it, all right?
You just take it easy, please.
There's something wrong with this, John. Something very wrong. Do you have a quarter? I want to call Robert.
We are not calling Robert. We've already talked to Robert. We have no proof.
She's a homicidal maniac.
Look, if you keep this obsession about Olivia going, you're going to end up with a nervous breakdown.
I'm being obsessive. I apologize. But I'm a good cop, Sean. And you taught me that a good cop never gives up on a case until it's over.
Anna, I know that.
I'm not closing this case until I've got her.
You know, I'd love to help you, but I am a surgeon, not an anesthesiologist, so I don't really have any specialized knowledge about that drug.
Well, you're more specialized than I am, that's for sure. I want to know your opinion about this reaction she had to the sodium pentothal.
Well, I'm not going to be able to tell you what you want to hear. I think Tom's right. It's an allergic reaction.
But don't you think she could have faked it, maybe?
No. It's a very powerful chemical. You know, I know how badly you want Olivia to get what she deserves. It's just not going to happen right now. You're going to have to wait for another opportunity.
But she should be in prison now, as we speak today.
The first thing that they teach you in medical school is to be patient. You move slowly, you get everything you need, and then you go at it.
Yeah, sorry. You made your point.
Another thing is, sometimes you want things so bad and you still don't get them.
I thought things were very encouraging for you.
Well, I'm not talking about my eyesight. Can I tell you something strange?
Yeah.
It was like Frisco was here today. Here, right here in this garden.
Oh. You know, I really like to think that they're still with us. I believe that, you know.
You know what today is?
No.
It's his birthday.
Oh, no wonder.
But it's more than that. See, he was here. I mean, I could feel him. It was like he was close to me.
That's really comforting, isn't it, don't you think?
I guess so. I just hope that Felicia doesn't feel these same feelings.
So nice.
Hi.
Nice to see you.
Good to see you, too, Arcas. Glad to get out of that townhouse. Donay has got me booking another 30 or 40 concerts, and then he's got me playing the Mendelssohn.
Oh, well, I'm glad you got driven away from the house, you know, because I'm here all on my own. Now, then she's gone out for the evening, and Robin's staying at a friend's house. I don't like rattling around here on my own so much these days.
No. Oh, I picked up the evening paper for you. Oh, and have you heard on the radio? It's probably in the newspaper as well. Victor Jerome has received the maximum sentence.
Oh, God, he's found guilty by jury. That's brilliant. Maximum sentence.
And the announcer said that he probably would spend the rest of his days in prison, and I thought you'd be thrilled about that.
I am.
So, it's over now, huh?
Well, no, not quite.
What do you mean?
It's not over for me yet.
Heating up some delicious homemade canned soup.
Are you? Mm-hmm. No, I'm not hungry, you know. This...
Anna, you are withering away to nothing.
That's the whole plan. Thanks.
Now, you still have this Jerome business on your mind, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
This is what you meant by it not being over for you, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, there's still, you know, some unfinished business that I have to take care of, and until I get her put behind bars, then I'm not going to be satisfied. Olivia Jerome. She's a very clever woman.
Yeah. You still don't believe this, what is it, selective amnesia business?
No, it's rubbish. Today, she agreed, right, to take sodium pentothal with Tom Hardy, and... She managed to get round it, and I don't know anybody else has ever done that.
You know what I think? I think we should put it all behind us and have some soup. What do you think?
Oh, I don't want soup. You know, I mean, you shouldn't be cooking soup in that frock anyway.
What should I be doing?
I don't know.
Making
fruit salad.
Hello. By any chance, is Dr. Tom Hardy still at the hospital? Thank you.
Anna, I'm glad I caught you at home. Hello, Catherine.
Hello. I'm sorry. I know you came to speak with Anna, so I'll be in the kitchen.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, so, is this about Olivia, though?
Well, Anna, it may be nothing, but... Uh-huh. Nora called me at the hospital. She'd seen the evening newspaper.
That one?
Yeah. She noticed the picture of Phil Leone on the front page.
Yeah?
She recognized him as a man she saw leaving Olivia's suite some weeks ago.
Phil Leone was with Olivia there?
Apparently.
I thought, correct me if I'm wrong, Olivia had said that was part of her memory that was gone, you know, would involve Phil and everybody.
Maybe, but remember, she reads the newspapers. She's also been to the library to dig up old editions to see if she could find anything that would jog her memory. She may have seen this picture in an old paper.
She doesn't need the library. She remembers everything.
It's possible she does. If so, I haven't caught her in one single slip-up. Neither has Nora,
And she keeps a very close eye on Olivia.
But Olivia is brilliant. I mean, she knows exactly what she's doing. She's faked this whole amnesia thing so she doesn't have to go to court.
Look, Anna, I'm not going to argue with you about this.
I never saw Phil Leanne's picture in the newspaper the whole time throughout the trial, and I never missed one paper.
Look, if I hadn't thought there might be a slip-up someday, I wouldn't be here tonight.
Okay. I'm sorry. You're right.
It's all right, I understand.
Did Nora hear any of the conversation?
No.
You didn't happen to ask her when this was?
Yes, I did. She keeps a diary when she's on assignment. No. She looked it up for me. It was Thursday, June 1.
Just a minute.
All right.
The day after Phil visited Olivia, Scott received an anonymous note. Remember the one with the magazine cut out?
Yes, it indicated that Phil took part in the conspiracy to kill Duke.
That was the second tip he got. Oh, my God.
What is it, Anna?
Victor's lawyer was right. Olivia was plotting to set her father up the whole time. See, now listen. The first tip that Scott received was Malone's number on Victor's hotel stationery.
Right.
And when that started to fall apart, and it looked like Scott was going to lose the case, then Olivia gives him Phil. And then when that starts to fall apart, right there in the courtroom, well, then she was forced to act. So she could get up there on the witness stand. Remember that whole display she did in the courtroom?
Yes, I do.
Okay, well, this is it. We've got her. This is the evidence that we need. This proves that she knew exactly what she was doing.
Hold it. Right there, Anna. You can't prove one damn thing.
No, I know, but you can see where it's leading, can't you? It's good.
Yes, I see where it's leading.
Yeah. All right, Tom, well, thanks. You know, I mean, for coming over, and you should go see Simone.
Yeah, I guess I should.
Right. Well, send her my love.
Okay? I will.
All right, maybe I'll come and see her tomorrow. And
she'd like that.
Yeah. Thanks.
Okay.
This is good.
All right.
Okay.
Bye.
Thanks. I've got to get on this. I've got to. Okay, now what have I got to prove this? I've got to talk to Scott. Hi.
Were you talking to me?
No, not anybody, really. I can get Olivia. Yeah, I can. Because Tom has just given her to me on a silver platter with the trimmings.
Yes.
Hi, it's Anna.
Yeah, well, what is it, love?
Can you come over here?
Now?
Yeah, right now it's important.
Is Catherine there?
Yeah,
she's here. In fact, if she hadn't been, I'd probably lost my mind by now.
Okay. Yeah, I'll be over.
Thanks.
You're thinking what I'm thinking?
Well, maybe Frisco went to Anna.
Yeah. She didn't say anything to me, but then again, Catherine's there. On the other hand, I don't want her or Catherine involved in this one.
You gotta tell her that I saw Frisco.
Not unless he's made some sort of contact with him. If he hasn't, then let's keep her in the dark. Right now, this guy is one magnet for any kind of danger going. I think he knows that, too. One thing he doesn't seem to know is how much he's gonna need us.
You know, that's gonna take one hell of a lot of convincing, Robert.
To be still alive. Hey, look, I'm sorry about that date.
Okay. I know, something came up.
Yeah, something major. Listen,
now. Right, hi.
You haven't had any phone calls, I should
know. Phone calls? No.
Phone calls.
No.
You know what? I'm going to let you two cops discuss all this.
Thanks.
I'll go make a pot of tea.
Okay, great. So, what's this case you're working on then, you know?
Nothing I need bother you with at the moment.
Oh, why aren't you telling me?
You called me, remember?
Yes, I did. Now, sit down. Okay, now listen. There's been a development with Olivia, right? Now, either Phil Leone is lying or Olivia is. And guess what? My money's on Olivia. So, we're going to question Phil. Now, he's still in prison, isn't he?
Yes, but what's that got to do with anything?
Well, no, this is very legitimate, Robert, I promise you.
In that case, I'll follow it up.
Well, now, listen. Very carefully. Right. Olivia saw Phil the day before Scott received an anonymous note from her. So that means she remembers everything, or else she wouldn't have tried to set him up. But then, of course, she had to risk her own neck when Scott came to a dead end with Phil on the stand, you know.
No, I don't. I have not the slightest idea what you're talking about. I have something a little more pressing on my mind at the moment.
Okay, well, anyway, well, then just bring Phil in tomorrow for questioning and let me be there because I know what to ask him.
Yeah, well, I can do it tomorrow.
Why not?
I told you.
Oh, the case.
Right.
Well, what is it?
Police business.
Yeah, well, you just don't want to get involved with my thing,
that is
do
not
you?
The
That's
reason at all.
No, it is, because this is very important and I think we can move on this. We have the evidence for it now.
Anna.
What?
You're becoming obsessed.
I'm not obsessed. Well, I am obsessed. I mean, what would have happened to Catherine if you hadn't felt that way about Paul?
That was different.
No, it wasn't any different. So, right, if you're not going to help me, well, then I'll do it myself.
Oh, look, just a minute.
No, thank you very much. Just leave. The door's that way.
Oh.
Thought I was the only one who brought up the best in you.
Well, she gets a little obstinate from time to time.
Who wouldn't be when pushed like that? I mean, it's very difficult to have been involved with a cop.
Well, it's very difficult to be involved with a concert pianist. And anyway, I've got to get back to work.
Yeah, I know. Well, that's all right. Don't worry about me. I didn't feel like going out tonight anyway.
Oh, come on.
No. You can't talk me into it. Sorry.
Well, I'd like to stay here and talk you into
come
it.
Come on, duty calls. Right. Come on.
As you say. All right.
And besides, I'm really proud of you that you're a dedicated cop, and I, for one, am grateful that you are.
Hell, I better get out of here before I mess up my hinge. I've got to deal with Victor's bodyguard. Phil, Anna, and I are going to talk to him today.
Still about Olivia?
Hmm. Listen, let's keep her out of this until necessary, all right?
All right. Got it.
Oh.
Hi.
Hi, Anna.
I'm sorry I was so horrible yesterday. I'm sorry, but I meant it.
Hey. Well, I was distracted myself.
Yeah, this big case.
Hmm.
Well, what is this case?
Oh, listen, nothing you need to know about just at the moment.
Right.
Look, Phil's downstairs in the interrogation room. Shall we?
Yes, let's go.
Okay. I'll stick around here, wait for word.
Yeah.
What is all this about?
Nothing.
Come on, one thing at a time, all right?
I really just wish that Nora had come forward sooner.
Glad she came forward at all.
I can't wait for this to be over.
Yeah.
What's this all about?
You can leave. Please have a seat. We just want to have a little bit of chat.
Look, I don't know anything about Duke Lavery's death, and nobody will listen to me.
I'll listen to you.
Oh, yeah?
We want to ask you some questions about Olivia Jerome.
That woman. I'm only in here because she lied on the stand.
Oh, she did lie, then, eh?
Now, Olivia maintains she overheard you and Victor plotting to kill Duke Lavery.
That's a lie.
An eyewitness says that they saw you leaving her hotel room during the trial.
Yeah, I was there.
Why?
Olivia asked me to come.
She asked you?
Yeah, she made out like she was worried about her father. When I think of how she turned against him at the trial,
What happened when you got to the room?
Well, she kept asking me about the case, whether I thought the evidence was strong enough to convict him.
What'd you tell her?
Told her the case looked pretty flimsy and that Victor was sure to get off.
How did she react to that?
Well, she seemed pretty upset. At the time, I just figured she was worried her father would be convicted.
More worried that he wouldn't be.
Go on.
Well, she kept asking me about Duke's death.
Asking what?
Whether I trusted the people Victor worked with, if there was anybody that might have overheard something that could possibly tie Victor to Duke's murder.
So she was looking for a witness.
It wasn't me, and I told Olivia that. I mean, I was really surprised when I was called to testify.
Would it surprise you that we received an anonymous note shortly after you left the room stating that you knew more than you admitted?
No. I bet Olivia was behind that, too. I wouldn't put anything past her.
Oh, would I?
She lied through her teeth on the stand just so she could send her father to prison. She set me up.
And you're saying she never heard you and Victor plotting to kill Duke?
No way. I'm telling you, I didn't know anything about it.
She lied then.
Can you prove that?
For one thing, Victor would never be dumb enough to talk about plotting to kill someone in front of witnesses, and especially not his own daughter.
No, he's far too clever for that.
He's
Bill's word against Olivia's, and that isn't proof.
Well, how do you prove a conversation that never happened?
I don't know.
But if we don't prove it, you're going to prison, and she isn't.
I'll stay put like it. I better go.
Oh, what is happening?
It's an emergency. Take him back to his cell, will you?
No, we haven't finished questioning him.
You can't question him without me.
Why not?
Regulations.
It's not the regulations.
Anna!
No!
Look, I don't have time. I have an important case
to
get.
This is very important.
I realize
that. We can get the evidence we need from him.
You don't have any proof, though.
Well, then why don't we question
Anna,
him?
Anna, not now. Please, or...
Hey, as soon as I heard what's going on...
Stay out of it, Baldwin.
What do you mean, stay out of it? It has to do with sending Olivia up the river. I want in.
Take this man back to his cell, guard.
Eight. This is Lavery. Anytime you want to talk.
Yeah, I'll be back.
What are you doing with Phil?
I don't have time to get
into
this.
What is the matter with you? We can get the evidence we need against Olivia now.
Come on, for crying out loud.
This time I am the investigator, and you are the prosecutor, and you will stay out of it until I say otherwise. I want it as badly as you do, but this isn't the time, all right? If she set the guy up, we will get her. Please, trust me. I've got to go.
What is this about Olivia setting Phil up?
It looks like that. We might have got some proof if he hadn't been too busy to question him.
I tell you what, why don't we go have some lunch and talk about Olivia's one-way trip up the river? So you really think Olivia was trying to set Phil up?
Oh, yeah, I'm convinced of it, yeah.
Come here, over here.
Oh,
Anna. Hiya, Ruby.
Anna, how nice to see you.
Oops, sorry.
If you were looking for Robert and Sean, you missed them. They just left.
Oh, yeah? Oh, yep. It's too bad. Listen, we're going to have some lunch.
Well, Turkey Club is the special today.
Turkey Club. Turkey Club.
Oh, no, I don't take offense.
Two Turkey Clubs and two cups of coffee.
Okay.
I don't want a sandwich.
No, it's good for you. You need to eat. Two sandwiches, Ruby. All right, so what are we going to do about Olivia?
What we've always been trying to do, prove that she is lying about everything.
You know, if I become as convinced as you are that she's lying, then she's done one hell of a job of playing possum.
Well, she has to. I mean, if she lets her guard down for 1 second, then she will have to answer for everything she's done.
Yeah.
There you go, Anna. Yeah,
thank you.
A little cream in there?
Oh, I did. Thank you. Right.
And what kind of a person sends her own father up the river?
She's a sick person. In her warped mind, this is a way of getting back at her father for killing my husband.
Anna, you know, I'm really sorry about the stuff that came out in Victor's trial about Olivia and Duke. You know, I'm sorry about that.
Well, it helped send Victor down. And you know what? I don't care what we use to put Olivia away.
Good. Well, we're going to do that. We're going to do that, I promise you, okay?
I really appreciate your support. I feel sometimes that Robert wants me just to forget about everything.
Well, I'll tell you something. Robert's right about one thing. If we can't prove that Olivia's faking amnesia, then we've got nothing.
Then you have to find a way to slip her up.
Well, I would like to. I would like nothing more than to put her right up the river with her father. You know what that would do to my career? And it's not just that my career that I'm concerned about here, either.
Scott, I don't care why you're doing it as long as you are doing it. Listen, I don't want you to put cream in my coffee. I don't want you to buy me a sandwich. I want you to nail Olivia for me, all right?
Okay. You pay for your own sandwich, and I'll nail Olivia.
I am like this because I feel Olivia is just as responsible for killing my husband as Victor.
Why exactly do you feel that way?
I was going to have his baby. If I'd had that child, you know, Robin and I, we would have had something of him left. Do you know what I mean?
I do. I know what you mean. But I want to be honest with you. Putting Olivia away, it's going to be tough.
Yeah. She's very clever. But we are too, aren't we?
Yeah. We're clever. So what we got to do is we got to find a way to slip Olivia up, you know, throw her off balance, do something.
Okay. Yeah, I'll think about it.
We will. You and I will come up with something, and we'll put Olivia away, I promise.
Hello.
Hi, Lucy. How are you?
Hi. I guess I have to go. Okay. Thank you.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Hang in there, Anna.
Yes.
Have a good day. See you later.
You too. Nice seeing you.
Okay. Sit down.